In this video, I will show you how to use priorities for Usenet downloads in SubNZBD and how you can take advantage of this useful feature. First of all, let me explain how priorities in SubNZBD work in general. You can assign a priority to each Usenet server you add into SubNZBD. As soon as you start downloading files, SubNZBD will search for these files on the server with the highest priority. If the files are not available on the server, it searches for these files on the next server in the row. I will now explain how you can take advantage of this feature by using the Usenet provider Frugal Usenet. Frugal Usenet offers you three different options how you can download files. The first server gives you unlimited download access to the Hivewinds backbone with a retention of 2600 days. The second server grants you limited access to the Usenet farm backbone with a retention up to 3000 days. Last in the row is the block server, which grants you access to the Hivewinds backbone, but this time with 4600 days of retention. So why not using the block new server as the main server? The answer is simple. Only the first server grants unlimited access and the others only grant limited access. The Usenet farm server is limited to 1.5 terabyte per month and the block new server only gives you 300 gigabyte for an entire year. So your goal should be to use the unlimited server first, and only if a file can't be found there, SubNZBD should use the limited options. As lower the number is chosen, as higher the priority is. For the unlimited options, I choose 0 as priority. The first two servers are the same and are both unlimited, but one is located in the European Union and the other one is in the United States. This allows me to use it as backup server in case of a problem with the European server. The bonus server is the Usenet farm backbone and I will give him a lower priority, and the lowest priority will be assigned to the block new server. With these settings, I try to make sure that my limits are not reached on the last two options. Another feature which SubNZBD provides is the parallel download of different servers. You can achieve this by assigning the same priority level to two different servers. You should only take care about the maximum allowed connections if it's the same provider. In my case, it is the same provider, only the server locations are different. By activating this option, I can download a file from two servers at the same time. You can clearly see how this works in the connection overview.